if we move ahead and see that as far as DRM is concerned, there has been over the years laws being formed internationally, and there's an organization, world organization called World Intellectual Property Organization, which had a copyright treaty in 1996. By that treaty, it was mandated that individual countries and nations should make laws in respect of DRM in their respective countries. And for the first time, US came with their own statute about the digital rights management in the year 1998. Thereafter, Digital Millennium Copyright Act 1998, China brought internal regulations, and European Union in 2001 brought directives about the digital copyrights. In India, we already had a Copyright Act of 1957, which was amended in 2002 because India was not the party to this treaty. It was not a member of the treaty, and that is why India in 2012 brought a wholesale amendment into the Copyright Act and added Section 65A and 65B, which talked about DRM. And DRM was criminalized in India, that if you manipulate and maneuver DRM or try to circumvent DRM, then you are liable to be punished. 65B also criminalized it, stating that if you violate DRM info, even then it is a punishable offense. Exceptions, though, are not created in these sections, but the language of 65A and 65B suggests that over and above criminal action, one can also be liable for civil action and may have to end up paying compensation if you circumvent the DRM. Now, moving ahead, there are these laws in place, and one has to go on to understand these developments in the field of law, but due to the paucity of time, we cannot go on explaining these different kind of DRMs and the laws related to those. Only thing is that there are certain shortcomings also in the method of DRM. One is reliability, because most of the DRMs work on web, on internet, and if the server is down, your reliability of DRM is under question. Then another is, there is obsolescence. Products, as I said, Zune with Play for Sure became obsolete. Then there is also ownership issues, that sometimes a person says that I have purchased a product, how could somebody else is controlling my ownership? Because if you purchase a land, purchase a house, that it becomes yours, nobody else can infringe. But here by the DRM, actually the seller is controlling your use. So that ownership issue is also a shortcoming of DRM. And then it's technically breakable. जैसे मैंने कहा कि आपके tangible property को चोरों से डर है, DRM को hackers से डरने की ज़रूरत है. Hackers, they can break inside your digital rights and they can steal your product, they can copy, they can distribute, they can multiply. So these are the shortcomings, and DRM में regular innovations हो रहे हैं, बहुत सारी चीज़ें मार्केट में आ रही हैं, नए नए प्रोडक्ट्स डिजिटली लॉन्च हो रहे हैं. अभी ऐसा सुनने में आ रहा है कि पब्लिशिंग हाउसेस आर आल्सो शिफ्टिंग टू सॉफ्टवेयर, बिकॉज बुक्स पब्लिश करना आउटडेटेड होता जा रहा है, बुक्स को अपडेट करना कॉस्टली हो रहा है. तो आई एम श्योर दैट अगर ये जो कसरत पेरुमल जी कर रहे हैं ये कंटिन्यूड रहती है कई सालों तक के लिए, दो चार दस साल बाद, तो शायद आपकी लाइब्रेरीज में बुक्स रिप्लेस हो जाएंगे और सिर्फ डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी बनकर रह जाएंगे वो. computers will be replacing all the books, and the books will be a matter of archive and museums, like so many things has already happened in this world. I am so thankful for this august institution, the organizers, the principals of two institutions, Dr. Priya Shah, Dr. Newton Madiwal, Perumalji, Hemant Shete, and my Rajadeksh ji, a very dear friend, and all the audience jo yahan par aaj upasthit hai, kuch mitra mere, Sharma ji, Shreyans, mere invitation par aaye hain. To aap sabko bahut dhanyawad, aur umeed karte hain ki aap DRM se aage fayda uthaye, aur aise bahut sare mauke aaye jahan par aap DRM ke bare mein baat kare. Thank you so much.